know, if you were at the airport and maybe you have to catch maybe a connecting flight, or maybe you gotta go somewhere, okay? You're at the airport and you wanna use the bathroom. And now this using of the bathroom, you know, you have to use the bathroom pretty urgently. And you go to the stall and guess what? When you open that stall door, you know what you see? Poop. Not just poop. You see like the smear, you know, on the seat. Smear everything, even 2 inches in front of your feet, you see some other artwork.
Okay. So you have to pee or you have to?
You have to. No, you have to also download. So now you go into the store and you see this, right? Now tell me, will you go and sit on that?
No, I like hover.
Will you hover? Over you? Like wow. What would you actually do? You probably just go to the next stall, right?
Oh, what?
You go to the next stall, okay?
The only available one.
You know? No. It's a bathroom. The airport bathroom, pretty vacant. Okay. So you see that? You won't sit down on top of that. God forbid. God forbid, I hope you wouldn't. Dirty. You go to the next one, right? Or what if there was no other one available? What would you do? Okay, now use the bathroom. But what if you now there's some situation where you can't just say I'm not going
to
use it. There's some situation where you
clean it real quick.
Call somebody to clean it real quick. Or what else?
Use the family restroom.
Use the family restroom. Okay. You might call somebody to clean it. Or if you are in a situation, what if someone says, no, I'm not going to clean that, what you going to do? Remember, this is a dire moment, sir. Mm-hmm. You need to release. What you got? Your pants? What you got? What that mean? You look, it may come down to you having to, you know, wipe and just, you know. But let me tell you, all your answers, right? Even the answer that you didn't say that's in your head, they don't involve you sitting on that stuff, okay? It's either that stuff goes or you go. Or you're going to grow on yourself, okay? That's how it's going to go, okay? Go. Now, that's kind of how it is with the Holy Spirit and our bodies. The Holy Spirit's not going to dwell inside of you if he sees some doo-doo or some sin, some dirt. He's like, wait a minute, It's either that goes or I'm not going in there. The same way you're not gonna go in there. Even hovering will be a struggle. You wouldn't even feel comfortable. Hovering's never comfortable, by the way. Okay, it's never more comfortable than sitting down, okay? Even if you had to use that same stall, it'd be uncomfortable. And that's how it is with the Holy Spirit, okay? If you have dirt or sin in your life, he's not going to stay in there. No. He's going to go to the clean person. He's going to go to the person that's ready, that cleaned this, that's like, okay, I'm ready. Take all this away from me, Lord, I'm ready. That's how it is, okay? That's how it is. Anytime you think about sin, see it as duty, okay? And you stay away from it, no matter what kind of sin it is. Music, shows, your language, what you do, all alone, your mindset. See, sin is doo-doo, okay? Someone sane doesn't just go and play with doo-doo, okay? So you should never just play, dabble with, oh, just a little bit of doo-doo. No, it's sin. Okay, let's go to John 3.